After quite possibly the worst day ever.
For some reason our electrics are not working in the van.
Crawling all over our kids' faces.
On our last episode, you left us gunning it through to the Italian Riviera earlier than planned due to the lack of park-ups on the south coast of France. On driving through Deva Marina, which is the starting point of the famous Cinque Terre, we managed to secure the last pitch on a tiny little site there. We were super thankful to eat and rest after a long 6-hour drive and to have a decent shower and wash the leaning tower of dishes that we'd built up at the Verdon Gorge. After a restful night's kip and a few extra mozzie bites, we were back on the road again. With flights from Florence to Brussels booked, we needed a safe place to leave our van baby for 48 hours, and this is how we came to stop at Camping El Poggetto.
Hey guys, just eating my lolly. I just kicked Mama. She said I'm sticky wicky. Mickey,
Ricky. Sticky Mickey, what? Brad and Hayes here checking in. We're in Florence in our campsite. Camping Il Poggetto, I think it's called. Family Poggetto. It is warm and there's going to be a thunderstorm. Bodie wants a pen pal.
I've already made one.
What were their names?
Dan and Anna. They were such good friends.
Maybe pen pals, aren't you? Write letters to them.
Yeah.
Cool.
Hello, guys.
What are you doing, Hayes?
We're just checking out our like camp place.
Yeah. This gentleman's taking us to find our pitch.
It's raining.
As the stormy clouds darkened our day, every cloud does indeed have a silver lining when Chris's horrendous free flip-flops were finally laid to rest in the bins of Camping Il Poggetto. Happy flipping days.
Bye-bye.
The turnaround was quick and it was bittersweet leaving our Grom. We were excited to get into Florence and explore the city, but the prospect of leaving our van and its contents unattended for a few days left us feeling unsettled. We soon got over this though when we laid on a real bed in our Airbnb in Florence. Sus Grom!
Florence, baby, on our way to Belgium.
I'm dying, by the way. Oh my gosh. Chris is trying to get for like £2.
Well, he's right and all, Rodney. I mean,
oh shit. Bodie owns it, even though we haven't paid for it. There we go, guys. So old. Yeah, show us the back then. Thanks, guys.
Gareth Bale!
Oh. What's the name of this restaurant?
This is Habitat in Firenze, which is like a sushi place. Good vegan place.
The boys have got some football shoes.
I even drawn a picture of Massey and it's Dudes.
Dude, Massey is the best.
I'm in Florence with Audrey Hepburn.
Actually, Sophia. Fun.
And the Groms. And the mother of Grom. We've left Grom in a campsite just outside Florence. She's got us all the way here. We've come into Florence to check out some markets, to get an early light, to get on a flight, to go to Belgium, to watch Coldplay, to see some friends, Adam Rowe and Andrew Rowe, Bethan and Kath. And then we're going to fly back here and go to Grom. We're going to have a couple of days in Florence.
And to fly into Brussels.
And no, we fly into Brussels tomorrow morning, aren't we? Yeah, Brussels and Brussels.
Yeah.
They're sidetracking me. And then we're going to go see some friends in the Pisa, Ponsacco region. And then we're going to be pushing northwards to Lake Garda. Liechtenstein, Germany, etc. But it's been all good, all good. Whatever that means. See you soon. Bye.
There's coffee, dishes and stuff.
I can always count on Chris to book something weird and wonderful. And as much as we would love to have stayed longer under the eyes of dead Hollywood movie stars, it was time to fly to Belgium. Our host mentioned at least 47 times that if we were leaving in the early hours, we had to make sure we left quietly. Believe me, this was tricky with a 6-year-old sugared up on chocolate chip brioches.
That we could get on the flight to Brussels, but our plane was an hour late, so we can't really get on.
So we missed our flight. We're just at the transfer desk waiting to see if they can get us on another flight to Brussels today, praying, because we're only there for one night for Coldplay tonight, so a bit of a nightmare. Fingers crossed, heads.
I guardato nei miei occhi e certamente avrai capito che l'amore non si spiega, è qualcosa che...
After Chris pulled off the biggest blag of the century, we were well rested and our tummies full of free food and drinks. I say drinks, but I mean endless coffees, after he tried to order one at the bar speaking Italian, but ended up with seven.
Anton.
Hello.
Oh my god, we made it to Belgium.
Finally getting the car, guys. Bugs.
Even though we were delayed by 6 hours, we got there just in time to catch up with our friends and chill out before the show. This show was extra special, as I got to reconnect with my old pal Christian, who I had many, many joint birthdays with at Cardiff Barfly. 28th of January forever, baby! He also gave the kids an awesome tour of the technical side of Coldplay, which we'd never seen before.
This concert is powered by renewable energy. Backstage generator runs on recycled cookieware. We charge our show batteries with solar, wind, and other green energy. You can power the show by using the power banks and kinetic floors.
Even though we want to show you the glory that is Coldplay, we need to also try and circumnavigate copyright. So here's a bunch of 2 second clips. Pray for us after all of this, we don't get busted for the ET soundtrack. After a 24-hour day and getting to bed slightly boozed at 4 a.m, we woke up to a beautiful day with temperatures reaching 38 degrees. After bidding our Airbnb, dreamy bed and dear friends farewell, we headed off to explore the centre of Brussels in the remaining few hours we had left here.
We are in Brussels.
We're in Brussels, heading to the Grand Place, just before we jump on an aeroplane. It's hot, we fly back to Florence via Munich. We've got some very grumpy kids.
Very grumpy kids.
Have I ever tried a waffle in Belgium?
Yeah.
No, I've never been to Belgium.
Hey, have you ever tried a waffle?
Oh.
Yeah, Belgian waffle.
How's the authentic Belgian waffle?
Let the tarps fall off the temporary homes that we have made and broken down bodies, watching hearts just pump the blood away from every vein I thought brought us closer to the truth. Buried in the permafrost, we numb the pain and fall in love.
And you'll miss it. Sad to leave, glad to be going back to Italy. Hopefully the van is still at the campsite.
No laughing.
They keep on telling me I'm wrong for falling in love. And they keep on telling me I gotta learn to move right.
I'm your father.
Right on. Build our bridges skyward, hope to hell to dry while holding all the drawings of forever seen. Misses touch and fall into nothing but isolating pink and squishy stuff made of tiny bits of shattered glass. Whole broken windows, not enough for me. They keep on telling me I'm wrong for falling in love, and I'll keep on telling them to F right off.
It's a thunder and lightning storm. Here comes the ride. It was absolutely pelting it then. No wonder they had us evacuate the pool. I hope the Fiamma awning holds. Apparently you're meant to angle it. Maybe this is what camper van holiday is all about. As long as we protect the mat though, right?
100 euros.
Last night we had a water ingress, they would call it officially, into the van. There was a massive electrical storm and the wife woke up to say there was drip, drip, drippings by the extractor fan. So we put up a towel, about as good as it gets. And now it seems to be dry.
Yeah.
Right?
Hello guys, we're just having lunch, it looks really dark. We're just in Italy.
Whereabouts?
Florence, and after we might go in the swim pool if it's open, because there's lots of thunder and lightning.
What do we have to wear in the swimming pools?
Swimming hats, like.
So we need a bag.
For nipples.
Yeah. For nipples?
Nipples.
Mm.
Is it on nipples?
That's your dad's.
And what's mum cooked us?
Cheesecakes for us three and Beau's got pasta.
And it's really delicious.
Yes, it is really delicious.
I'm not, I was doing that in my teeth.
Oh no,
where are we at, Hayes? Tell us a little bit about Tuscany.
It's fun.
Okay. And the pool?
Yep.
It's a really quality pool. It's a holiday, babe.
Get me the Prosecco.
Thank you.
Watch your weapons, there are those that you covet. And the last thing we need is an obituary feed that scrolls the names of your own. So if it's true that we've all forgotten something.
It's gonna be 7 months of practicing. I'm just hearing you.
All right.
being complete legends and joining us for our arrivals into Italy. We have only just scratched the surface of our travels around Europe, so make sure you click the subscribe button to be the first to know about our next episode. And if you're feeling really lush, give us a like too.
Must be the children that Moses led, let my people go.
Who's that yonder dressed in red?
Must be the children that Moses led. Go tell it on the mountain to let my people go. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere.
Your tooth crown out, Bo. Yeah. Big smile for Mama.